Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to show and explain you the most important key combinations for ABAP developers, so for the ABAP editor. Watch till the end, because in the end, I have a nice surprise for you. And enjoy this video. Let's get started. I think one of the most important key combinations in the ABAP editor is Ctrl Z. With Ctrl Z, you can correct or jump one step back to your previous input. So for example, if you delete anything in here and you would like to correct it, then you can use Ctrl Z to correct your action and go one step back. With Alt and your mouse, there you can select any part in the ABAP editor. So now I hit the Alt key on my keyboard, and then as you can see right here, you can select any part that you want to. So for example, if you just would like to select the USR in this name, then you can just hover over this part. If you would like to comment any line in the ABAP editor, then you can use Ctrl and comma. If you would revert this, if you would like to use the statement once again and to comment this in, then you can use Ctrl dot to remove the comment. If you would like to set the focus into the command field, then you can use Ctrl Shift 7 and then you set the focus into this command field. If you would like to work with bookmarks, then you can use Ctrl Alt and an ID or a number between 1 and 9 to create a bookmark or to remove it. So for example, if you would like to set a bookmark in this line, then you can use Ctrl Alt and then any number between 1 and 9. And here in the left column, there you can see that there a blue flag has been created with a number, and the number is depending on the number that you have used. So for example, if I hit the 1, then we see now the 1. If I hit Ctrl Alt and 2, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if you would like to jump to this bookmark, so now I set the focus on line 8 and would like to jump to this bookmark, then you can use Ctrl and the number or the ID of this bookmark. So here we have the bookmark 9. And if I use Ctrl 9, then I directly jump to this bookmark. If I would like to remove this bookmark, then once again, I can use Ctrl Alt and the ID of this bookmark 9, and then I have removed this. If you would like to move one line above, then you can use Ctrl Alt and T, and then you can move this line above. With Ctrl C, then you can copy a word, a statement, a part, what you like to. So for example, if I select this and use Ctrl C, then I can copy it, and with Ctrl V, I can paste this in. If you would like to duplicate one line, then you can use Ctrl D to duplicate specific lines that you want to, and with Ctrl and F2 you can do a syntax check. With Ctrl and F3 you can activate your coding. So for example, if I delete it, use Ctrl F2 to do a syntax check, and then use Ctrl F3, then I have activated this coding. With Ctrl I can do a so-called incremental search. So you directly search with your input. So for example, if I'm using P_test, then you can see that directly, depending on my input, this search has been executed, and you can end your search with the Enter key on your keyboard. So now I have hit the Enter key on my keyboard. If you would like to do it backwards, then you can use Ctrl Shift I, and then, for example, again, P underscore test, and then you can do it backwards. And with Enter, once again, you can end this search. If you would like to capitalize the first letter of a word, then you can select one word, and you can use Ctrl J to capitalize the first letter of this word. If you would like to switch the capitalization in one selected word, then you can select one word or a sentence, and then you can use Ctrl K to switch it. So now we've seen that the P, the first letter, was capitalized and the other letters were low. And now I have used Ctrl K, and now it has switched. I'm using the key combination a couple of times, and every time it switches. With the very, very important key combination Ctrl and Space, you can open up the options for your code completion. So now I hit Ctrl Space, and now you're seeing all the possible ABAP statements that you can use. And if you stay or set the focus on one statement for a longer time, then you directly see on the right side the ABAP keyword documentation. This is really, really nice. And with Enter key on your keyboard, you can take this over. And it is really important that the statements or the words will be proposed based on your input. So, for example, if I would have used loop and then using Ctrl Space, then, for example, a very, very important word or statement is add, and then it will be proposed. So this is really, really nice. If you want to jump to one specific line, then you can use Ctrl O, and then you can type in the line number. So in this case, between 1 and 34, so maybe to 26, and then you can directly jump into this line. If you would like to save your coding, then you can using Ctrl and S to save it, and now you have saved your coding. If you would like to delete a whole line, then you can use Ctrl Shift and L to delete the whole line, or you can also delete the whole line with Ctrl Shift and X. With the tab, you can move the whole line to the right, and with Shift and Tab, you can move the whole line to the left. If you would like to format your coding with the pretty printer, then you can use Shift and F1 to use the pretty printer. And under Utilities and Settings, and then pretty printer, there you can set up the settings for the pretty printer. And in my case, if I would like to activate my coding, then every time I'm using Shift and F1 to use the pretty printer, then Ctrl F2 to use the syntax check, and then Ctrl F3 to activate this. And as mentioned in the beginning of this video, here I have listed you all the most important key combinations shortcuts for ABAP developers, for the ABAP editor. And now I would like to know, what are your most important key combinations in the ABAP editor? Put it in the comment sections. And if you have some questions, also you can ask me every time. And don't forget to subscribe to not miss any very interesting upcoming videos. And then thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.